Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
I am answering your summons.
We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Your shout will not harm us.
All right, here goes.
Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar.
Thank you.
I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
Really? You're the one that summoned me?
We are honored to welcome a Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny.
What is my destiny?
That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination.
I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
Wait a minute. You mean I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only Dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
All right then, I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, a second word in Unrelenting Force.
Everything all right?
Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Ro!
What? Just happened.
But learning a word of power is only the first step. You must unlock its meaning through constant practice in order to use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro.
Master Einarth, you're giving coursing through my veins.
Do you need something?
No, you'd better get back, Mjoll. I feel so powerful.
Use your shout to strike the targets as they appear.
What targets?
Yosa!
Oh, I see.
Well,
what was that?
Again.
Yosa!
Again, well, yes.
Once more.
All right.
Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
What's next?
We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
All right, Mjoll. Don't worry. You can stay here if you'd like. I really like those robes. The textures are quite incredible and intricate.
Master Bori will teach you Kest, Tempest, the third word of Whirlwind Sprint. You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb.
Oh, here it is.
Approach Master Bori, who will gift you his knowledge now.
Which one is Wolfgar?
Master Bori. X. Now, it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Before.
Your quick mastery of a new thumb is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself.
I thought it was this easy for everyone.
No, indeed not. Beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom. You are now ready for your last trial.
What? Another
Please
one?
The horn of Jörgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengraf. Remain true to the way of the voice. You will return.
I do have a few questions before I go. Why are the dragons returning? Does it have anything to do with me and my new power?
No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear.
Surely, there's more you can tell me.
There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it. Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many Dragonborn before you.
I think it's already too late for that, Angar, and you know it. Now tell me, who is Jürgen Windcaller?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
What is the way of the voice?
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
But I don't follow your philosophy. In fact, I even enjoy killing. Why would you help me learn the voice?
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals.
All right, thank you.
Sky, guard you.
And Akatosh take you. Let's go. Mjoll. We've arrived at Ustengrav. Supposedly there's a horn here. Let's go. Wait. More death. Starting to feel like almost everyone in Skyrim is dead. What has been happening? Look, another body. And the chest has also been looted. All right, let's go inside. More killing. Wait.
Ah! Enough!
Every shot missed. is that every time I aim, that they step in the direction away from the arrow. All right, we've got some necromancy going on over here too. That's down. All right, I think that other person, there's a corridor over there on the left. You can't hide from me. See you burn. Don't you see? Is he undead? Stay on guard. Let me check out these bodies. No, neither one of them were vampires. But they burned at the touch of Ariel's bow. That one of them anyway. Burn, mother... I mean... enemies of mine. Of something else's. Did that just miss completely? Thank you. you're still with me. Somebody parted with their coin purse. All right. Let's go inside Ustengrav Depths. Wow, those are some depths, all right.
Never seen such a thing.
Just stay on guard. So he's on his way. Save the magic for someone who cares. this. Further ahead. This is almost like cheating having Oriel's bow.
quite a few Nord ruins in my day.
Hopefully this is the last of the Draugr, but we'll see. Alright, come on, come quickly. Come on before the... Come! Get in here!
I've never seen such a thing.
Goodness, what the... That gate closed and you got trapped. Wouldn't be anything I can do. Alright, this looks safe. Sort of. Read mysterious note. I need to speak with you urgently. Rent the attic room at the Sleeping Giant Inn in Riverwood and I'll meet you. A friend, really? So much for the horn.
Can you just imagine how ancient this place must be? Hundreds of years.
So there's nothing else here. Alright then. I suppose we're going. I guess our next stop is Riverwood, and we'll go there next time.